We're continuing our paranormal tour of Ohio, and this week we're stopping at what may be the most haunted place in the entire state. Now, if you've seen any ghost hunting shows, you're probably somewhat familiar with the Ohio State Reformatory. Built in 1890, the prison started as an intermediate penitentiary for first-time offenders. But when the prison population expanded in the early 20th century, the reformatory was forced to accept more violent criminals. By the 1960s, the prison became so crowded that guards were forced to double the occupancy on death row, which led to an increase in violence and even the death of one inmate. Now, the increased occupancy also allowed disease to run rampant. Over 200 people died while incarcerated at the reformatory due to disease, violence, and on some occasions, suicide. The prison shut down in 1972 following a class action lawsuit over the inhumane conditions. Nowadays, the reformatory has become a tourist attraction. Many films have actually used the prison as a backdrop, including, Shawshank Redemption and Air Force One. Now, because of its history, the site has also become a hotspot for paranormal researchers. Now, many guests claim to hear disembodied voices and see shadowy figures. Some have even claimed that they've been pushed or punched by the ghosts. Now, if you'd like to dive further into the history of the reformatory, the prison offers many self-guided tours from the paranormal to a Shawshank walkthrough. Our next stop is the Palace Theater in Canton. Henry Harper, Inc. built the theater in 1926 as a gift to the community. While there were 9 other local movie theaters at the time, the Palace stood out with its impressive design, meant to look like a Spanish courtyard on a midsummer night. To this day, the theater has maintained much of its original design, including its original fog machine and even organ, and still has the largest screen in Canton. The theater fell out of popularity in the 60s and 70s and experienced neglect and decay. But an effort to restore the theater to its glory form took place in the 80s. Now today, the Palace Theater is a cornerstone of the Canton Arts District, offering over 300 different events a year. While the history of the building may be fun, we're here to talk about the ghosts. And the Palace Theater certainly has a tale or two. The most prominent ghost is that of Banks Kennedy, the palace's original organist. Rumor has it, in 1930, Kennedy was shot in the basement. Now, after his death was ordered by a mob boss, some other ghosts that are frequently spotted are one of a little girl who can be seen from the balcony, and the ghosts of former theater owners. And since the theater is still operational, you can head over there to catch a show, including their annual showing of the Rocky Horror Picture Show. And for our last stop, we're heading to the Franklin Castle in Cleveland. Built in the 1880s by Haynes Teeterman, the house was plagued with tragedy. Now, while at the house, Teeterman lost his mother, 15-year-old daughter, and 3 infant children. The intricate designs and expanding rooms were said to be a distraction from the constant barrage of deaths. Unfortunately, his wife would also die at the house. Future residents would also claim to hear babies crying and see mysterious women in black, which they attributed to the family members who passed away. Now, after Tiedemann sold the property, the building spent several decades as a German cultural center. Now, before going back to private ownership in the 1960s, more stories of hauntings and gruesome crimes, they began to crop up, including an axe murderer attacking his victims on the property, and even a mass shooting of Nazis. Now, many of these stories take place in the tunnels beneath the building, which is a bit suspect since there are no tunnels. Now, many believe that a previous owner made up those tales in order to place the Franklin Castle on the paranormal map.